Today, I invite you for an exciting train adventure from Malaga to Madrid, covering a distance of 512 kilometers. Hop on board the high-speed train affectionately known as Duck and experience the breathtaking Spanish scenery as we zip along at 300 kilometers per hour. Join me as I showcase the train's sleek design, cozy interiors and inviting bar. We'll also delve into all the details about the trip, tickets and prices. Come along! Hola y bienvenidos a Málaga, María Zambrano. Hi and welcome to a still half-asleep Málaga, María Zambrano. I'm here today to show you RENFE's class 102, nicknamed Pato, the Spanish for duck, in a trip to Madrid, Puerta de Atocha, in preferente class. Málaga's train station is almost unique in its location inside a shopping mall. This means there are numerous shops of all kinds close to the trains. Other than some cafes, they are still closed at this early hour, but during the day this station is bustling with activity. It has 8 overground and 2 underground tracks that are used by the local Malaga commuter services, which extend as far as Fuengirola. Passing beneath the departure boards, we reach the platforms and find a long queue of passengers waiting to go through security and ticket checks and board the train to Madrid. Pre-boarding checks are common in some countries, including Spain. What are your thoughts on these controls? Do you find them useful, or do you think they make train stations too similar to airports? Let me know in the comments below. Our duck is already at the platform, so let's check it out. These trains were designed and built by Talgo, although the power technology is from Bombardier. They are certified for a maximum speed of 330 km per hour. Each train has 2 locomotives and 12 articulated Talgo 350 passive tilting cars, for a total of 318 seats. They entered service in 2004. Time to board and check the interior of our Clase Preferente Talgo car. There are 26 leather seats in this very neutral car. Let's walk a little bit and check the cafeteria while there aren't many passengers around. Time now to check today's map for our 512 km trip from Malaga to Madrid, with stops at Antequera Santa Ana and Córdoba. Given the early hour at which we departed, we weren't able to see anything outside. Now I can show you the scenery. The line from Malaga to Córdoba spans 150 km and includes 19 bridges and 8 tunnels. The arrival at Antequera Santa Ana is at a low speed, and we end up stopping for 13 minutes while another class 102 is coupled to our rear. I use this time to show you the seat. It's a quite comfortable armchair type leather seat. This sticker conveys the instructions to connect to the onboard internet. More on this in a minute. There's a footrest, a litter bin, and, of course, this nice table. Beneath the seats, there are these 220-volt power sockets and above, individual reading lights. On the sides, several channels for music and connected to the TV. Earphones are available at the cafeteria. Further entertainment is available through RENFE's app Play RENFE, which can be accessed by AVE's passengers. The app offers live TV, movies, TV shows, kids entertainment, etc. and is compatible with passengers' phones, tablets and computers. Both the app and the onboard internet work well and at very good speeds. Departure from Antequera is at 8:13 with a 16-minute delay. Although there's a rolling minibar, I always prefer to grab a snack at the train's cafeteria and have my own version of food and scenery. Córdoba Mercancías signals that we are near our stop at Córdoba, a breathtaking city with several buildings classified as World Heritage Sites by UNESCO. It's a true treasure, well worthy of a visit. Our stop here is brief, and soon we are underway again. With the train rolling fast to Madrid, I go for a stroll to show you the Clase Turista. Albeit in a 2+2 configuration, it's also quite comfortable and there's no major loss, comfort-wise, in traveling here instead of in Preferente. RENFE's La Sagra workshops signal that Madrid is only 50 km away. At these workshops, RENFE conducts maintenance for several of its high-speed train classes. Even though we left Cordoba 16 minutes late due to the time lost at Antequera, we are still on schedule to reach Madrid, thanks to the generous buffer built into this train schedule. Currently, we are stopped at Puerta de Atocha's home signal, providing me with a good opportunity to share my thoughts about the trip and discuss ticket prices. It's a quick trip through fantastic scenery on board the train with reasonable rolling quality. The seats are comfortable, the interior design inspires calmness and relaxation, there are enough entertainment options, and the service is what we expect from RENFE. Great, attentive and professional. The cafeteria had a variety of options and the staff was very friendly. These are all reasons to choose this AVE service for traveling between Malaga and Madrid. However, the 13-minute stop at Antequera left me feeling that without it, we could have arrived maybe 10 or 12 minutes earlier at Puerta de Atocha. Overall, it's a service that I will undoubtedly use again. As for prices, I paid €67.65 for a ticket bought 18 days before my trip, which I think is a reasonable price for this time of year. Nonetheless, it's important to note that ticket fares are dynamic and change based on specific trains and how far in advance you buy them. Puerta de Atocha, along with Atocha Cercanías, is the main long-distance train station in Madrid, and both together are part of the Atocha complex. It also includes Madrid Metro's Line 1, along with buses, taxis and a car park. From Puerta de Atocha, passengers can easily transfer to Atocha Cercanías and catch commuter trains to reach their final destinations. Bear with me as we come to a stop and disembark the train for a final glimpse of our duck, RENFE's class 102, which flawlessly carried us all the way from Malaga. As I walk to the exit here at Puerta de Atocha and our trip is almost at its end, I want to thank you for coming along on this journey. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel and leave me a comment below. Your support is very helpful and indeed means a lot. Thank you for being here and see you in my next video.